Mr. Justin Lawson. Hello.
What's up, Chattanooga? Make some noise. Y'all here to see Preacher?
Yeah.
Well, he ain't coming, so. Thank you, the brother. Like doing stand-up. I travel a lot doing stand-up. I took a trip to Atlanta. Make some noise if you've been to Atlanta. Atlanta was great. Had a great time in Atlanta. Now my trip up to Atlanta, it sucked. I was trying to be cheap. I didn't want to spend a lot of money on an airline ticket. Ended up purchasing a ticket from the most ghettoest airlines on earth. And I know y'all heard of it because it's popular. It's called, Greyhound. Get off the ground, bro. I was like, it's the worst magic school bus on earth. Took the Greyhound to Atlanta. My bus driver was from the hood of Atlanta. So he was doing like his bus driver announcements. I didn't understand a word that was going on. I was like, I was confused. I need a Rosetta Stone. Like, it was that bad. He just got on the bus and like, all right, straight up. I'm your bus driver, that's me. Oh, we're not driving straight to Atlanta, man. But before we do that, I gotta do a few announcements. That way everybody on the same page, okay? Alright. Okay, big boy with the purple lips. Ain't no smoking on this bus. Put the weed out. Thank you. Ain't no drinking on this bus. And most importantly, ain't no sex on this bus right here unless you involve me. That's a new quick pep pep, and I'm gonna be right back, man. Ain't trying to keep it, just want to taste it. All right. All y'all gonna like this right here. I took the liberty of putting my mixtape under your seat. Yeah, so if you want to like pop in some tunes later, you put my mixtape in. And I get everybody. I was like, Oprah. I was like, you get a mixtape. Everybody get a mixtape. So pop my mixtape in, man. And guys, I put his mixtape in, and he was just doing bus driver announcements. I was like, this is state sucks, man. I'm from two different states, though. I was raised in Portland, Oregon, and Memphis, Tennessee. Portland, Oregon, yeah. I named two states. I didn't know what to do. Both of them are cool. It doesn't matter. Portland, Oregon, Memphis, they're very different from each other, though. Very different. This is how different. In Portland, Oregon, I went to school. I was the only black kid at my school. I moved to Memphis, Tennessee, sir. Went to school. I was considered the only white kid. I was like, what? This is weird. This is different right here. The Memphis kid like, you pronounce your word, bro, for real, straight up? I was like, I do, but I won't. If you don't want to, you want me to stop? I'll stop. I don't think it's sorry. It's crazy. One of the kids was telling me I wasn't black. That's what he told me. He told me I wasn't black. I was like, dude, I don't know if you see me. I'm not a flay-to-flay black, but I think this will work. Over here proving that I was black to other black people. That's so stupid. It's so dumb. Like, white people don't gotta prove they're white to other white people. That never happens. You'll never see a white, you don't see this Starbucks coffee? Huh? It says Connor on it, man. Connor, bro. That proved that I was black. It was making me angry, too, by the way he was doing it. He was like, you black, but you really ain't black. Like, you black, but you not black. What's this mean? What is this? I don't know if this is a Jedi trick or something like that. Because when he did that, I was like, maybe I'm not black. Maybe I'm Dominican. Wepa. I don't know my dad, so there's a chance. Bullied me because the way I was brought up. They bullied me. I'm not wearing my glasses now. I usually wear glasses. But they bullied me for wearing glasses, which is crazy because I like vision. You know what I mean? Like, I like to be able to see. I think that's pretty cool. What I don't like about glasses, they have fake glasses. They have people with 20/20 vision that wear fake glasses. All those people are dicks. You know what I mean? Like, it makes me so angry. Like, this is not a thing. I wish it was a thing. It's not a thing. I wish everybody with 20/20 vision that wear fake glasses gets AIDS in their eyes. I want them to earn it. You know what I mean? Feel my pain. I don't have AIDS in my eye. I'm just all right. When I sometimes, yo, because I got astigmatism though. Sometimes when I don't wear my glasses for too long, one of my eyes starts slowly drifting to the left on its own. It's like a Forrest Whitaker thing going on. Right? My eyes like fade off. almost was like, yeah, baby Walk is a rapper. I don't know. No, so I wear glasses so I can see, man. There's this girl I got into an argument with. She was trying to act like glasses was a fashion. It's not a fashion, it's a disability. Like, I don't know what you mean. She's like, it makes me look smart, it makes me look classy. I was like, no, you look blind. You don't get superpowers from this. It's not like Spider-Man when you get bit by a spider and then you Spider-Man around. You don't get bit by glasses and now you know the vision, okay? You just see you suck at the vision. It's a disability. You don't see me going to the clubs with crutches like, hey, where the party at? And they're like, Justin, you crippled? No, I just stopped crutches. Look at the pants. The fashion. Crutches, pants, lips. I'm trying to change the game, man. Plus, you can't fight with glasses on. Can't fight. Because people with normal eyes, they cheat. Don't fight you fair. For example, got to fight with this one girl, right? She does something totally unnecessary. She just walks up to me, she goes, fogs up my glasses, and beats me up. I was like, you can't do that. That's in the Bible. Jesus said. I was so angry. I had to get the girl back, but I don't hit women. I'm smart. You know what I did, sir? I walked up to her, I licked my thumb, and I wiped her eyebrow off. You gotta be smart. Now she can't be happy about what she did. She has no facial expression. We both lost. Watch some dudes try that tonight. What you say, man? Skinny jeans is a fashion. I wish it would stop. It's a horrible fashion, man. Skinny jeans. Fellas, if you're in here wearing skinny jeans, I want to let you know that skinny jeans are actually meant for people with skinny legs. If you have normal legs, fellas, and you wear skinny jeans, you just look like you're wearing leotards. Like, you're not fooling nobody. Like, I've seen this dude with skinny jeans. His jeans were so tight, you could see the text message in his pocket. Every time his phone rang, his whole leg was vibrating. I was twerking. I threw $11 in change on him. But that's what you think, man. But I tried skinny jeans, though. I tried it. I got tricked by this girl. She was beautiful. She was like, you should buy skinny jeans. I was like, why would I want to do that? I think that's a no for me. She's like, oh, you didn't know? The middle part, it pops up. It's like a pop-up book. You know, I love to read, so. Give me three. Let me get three of those jeans. What she did tell me is, like, when you wear skinny jeans and a big shirt, you look like an umbrella. It's very unattractive. So here I am looking like this umbrella walking down the street. Minding my business, right? I tried to do something simple with the jeans on. All I wanted to do was tie my shoes, right? All right. Tie my shoes, and I downloaded 40 apps for this position. Set me up. She wore Verizon or something. I don't want to wear the jeans anymore. It's because it gets my phone bill high. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to return them. I'm not going to wear these anymore. On the way to returning these jeans, I found out you cannot lie to a bum with skinny jeans on. Did y'all know that? You cannot lie to, because skinny jeans force you to tell the truth. Yeah. The bum came up to me and was like, hey, man, how you doing, my brother? You look nice. For real, I like the jeans. Listen, man, you got any, like, some spare change your brother can have or something, man? Some spare change for my brother? It's like, now I got a lot. It's like, spare change, no, don't have any spare change. But if I did, I'd give it to you. God bless. I tried to walk off, guys, he stopped me.
Wait a minute! You don't have any spare change, really? Really? Because I'm looking at your skinny jeans, I see 45 cents in your pocket, sucker!
I'll kill us both. And I was so scared, I ended up giving this dude $400 and 45 cents. That's how scared I was. For real, guys, I didn't want him to bite me and turn me homeless. And I think that's how it works. It's a documentary, Walking Dead, they're all homeless people. I live in LA now, so weed is a thing. I'm not promoting it, just letting you know. All right, you know, because I know it's not legal here, so, but LA, you know, just want to let y'all know that first before I say that I smoked weed before. And it's not meant for everybody. I'm gonna say that it's not meant for everybody because I messed around and I got so high that I robbed myself at gunpoint and I was like, this is not for me. This is not for me anymore. I was so scared because I remembered everything that happened. I remember walking past the mirror and I saw myself. I was like, fool, look like he got some light on right there. Freeze! I was like, wait a minute. Rob me, man. Are we the same person, man? That's stupid, man. He's like, shut up, man. Just give me all your money. Just don't shoot me. Please, Papa. There you go, man. There's my money.
He's like, man, why are you playing with me? I said, give me all of your money.
I don't have any more. I quit running, fool. I see 45 cents, you're skinny again.